Welcome, Pit Crew, to another video. For some of you guys, NVIDIA Surround or AMD iFinity works great. For some other people that use their computers for other than sim racing, well, it can make your life a nightmare. It can literally turn you into a monster. If you're in the latter group, well, I've got the fix for you. I'm going to show you how to set up triple screens without NVIDIA or AMD for titles like iRacing, ACC, AMS2, and help you dial in your FOV correctly. Before we get into the sim, we're going to have to take all the measurements of our monitors and our stand. It's really, really important to set things up correctly. So we're gonna have to measure our monitors, the angle of the monitors, the distance between our monitors and our eyes, and the bezels. So for this, we're gonna need either a measuring tape, a long ruler, and a protractor. So now when we do our measurements, we're gonna measure the width of our monitor. And the width for me was 69.7 centimeters. Then we're gonna measure the height. The height for me was 39.2 centimeters. Now we're going to measure our bezel width, and for me, my bezel width was 0.5 centimeters. And then now we're going to do is we're going to measure the distance from our eyes to the screen. And why I measured that, for me, I had 56 centimeters from all monitors. And then the last thing we're going to do is we're going to measure our monitor angles, you know, our side screen to our center screen. And if you've got flat screen monitors, you're going to measure straight from the monitors. But if you've got curved monitors, the easiest way to do that is to measure between the arms of your side monitors to the monitor stand. And for me, when I did that measurement, it was 76 degrees. And for me, I had to do that because I've got the ASUS Bezel Free Kit, and it's recommended that I have my monitor measurements, you know, from end of side monitor to the other end of the monitor between 112 and 116 centimeters.
All right, so let's get into iRacing first, since iRacing is really the easiest sim to set up when it comes to triple screen monitors without Surround or iFinity. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to our options. Then we're gonna go to graphics, and we're gonna make sure that full screen and border are unchecked. Once you've unchecked those two, then we can hit done and we can exit out of the sim. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go into the INI file of iRacing, and we're gonna do some changes in it. So the easiest way to get to it is go to my documents. We're gonna go to iRacing. Then we're gonna find our Render DX11 monitor. And we're gonna open that up with just your normal text editor. And here, we're gonna scroll down all the way down to display. And the big things that we're gonna be looking for here is windowed height, windowed width, and wind X position. Now these are the three things that we're gonna be adjusting. So our height is the vertical resolution of your monitor, meaning 1080p is going to be 1080, 1440p is going to be 1440. Then the width is the horizontal resolution of your monitors combined. So if you have 1080p monitors, that's going to be 5760, and then for 1440p, it's going to be 7680. And the actual size of your monitors here doesn't really matter. The next thing we're going to look at is wind X position, is the offset of the horizontal resolution of your middle monitors. So if we're gonna be using this, here we need to make sure that, you know, we're setting our WinX to 1920 for 1080p and then 2560 for 1440p. Once we've done that, we can save our file. And then we go to our display settings, and we gotta make sure that our center monitor is our main display monitor. Once that's done, we can actually go back into iRacing. So now that we're back in iRacing, we got to set up our monitors correctly. So in our graphics option in the menu, we go to monitors. And here, so for example, for me, I've got three curved monitors. So I'm going to have three curved monitors selected. You got the option between one flat screen, three flat screens, one curved, and then three curved screens. And so here for the monitor width, here's where we're gonna put in the measurement that we use to measure our monitors. For me, it was 31.97 or 32 inches, not really a big deal. And then the second block is where we're gonna put in our bezel width. So for me, because I'm using the Asus bezel screens, I don't have to worry about putting in a bezel width, but if you do have bezels, you need to make sure you measure those and you put them in here correctly. The next thing you wanna do is make sure if you're using curved monitors, you're putting in the right radius of curvature. And then for me, like, I want to make sure that, you know, that all three different screens are being rendered separately. So I've got these two options here selected. Now for the FOV calculator, this is where I'm going to put in the measurement that I measured from the distance of the screen to my eyes. So for me, it was 56 centimeters, which here is going to be 560 millimeters. And we hit done. Done, and now we can jump into the car to make sure everything is correct. So with the way I'm looking at it now, everything looks good for me. I don't have to change anything at all. And so guys, that is it for iRacing. And we're gonna move on to our next sim. All right, so next up is ACC. In ACC, it's the same as iRacing. You need to make sure that you're running in windowed borderless mode. So you gotta make sure that your full screen is disabled. Now, ACC doesn't really natively support triple screens without NVIDIA Surround or iFinity. So for that, you need to run an external tool. And it's called Simple Runtime Window Editor, or SRWE235. I'm gonna include a link for it in the description below. Once you've downloaded it and unzipped it, then we're gonna go into the folder and we're gonna run the file SRWE. Now you're going to get this window right here. Now here's a window is really going to trick ACC into thinking that you're running triple screens. All right, once you've got SRWE running, now we're also going to get ACC running. Once ACC is up and running, we're going to go to SRWE and we're going to select running applications. We're going to select AC2 Win64, hit open. Now it's going to give us some measurements here. So for width, we're gonna put in 7680. For height, it's gonna be 1440. We're gonna hit set. But now it's changed our monitor position, so we gotta fix that. So for X, we're gonna put in, to move that over more to the left, we're gonna put in -2560. And for Y, we're gonna change that to 0. Wait. -2560. Hit set, so that moves it. Now Y is gonna be 0. All right, so now you can see that we have our border up top. So to remove that, we're gonna hit remove borders. And now it's gonna make sure everything is set to our full screen of our monitors. So here is the really, really important part that we've gotta do. Now we've gotta save it. So we gotta select save. So we're gonna select AC2. We're gonna hit save profile. And we're just gonna put in ACC. Hit save. Yep, I'll replace it because we've already done this before. But anyways, so that's it right there. That's all you gotta do. And now we can actually go in game and fix our FOV. So to set up your FOV correctly, we're gonna hit drive, then we're gonna hit escape, so then we can go into our view settings. We're gonna scroll over to triple and widescreen. So here is we're gonna do some changes. So we're gonna do the distance from the screen. So for me, when I measured it earlier, it was 56 centimeters, which is 560 millimeters. Our screen width, which is 660. For me, we measured at 697. And now here is we're gonna do our bezel width. And this is really gonna be based off of how your monitors look next to each other. So we're gonna change that to see if we can fix it. I need to make it less. All right, so for me, at -6 looks good. And then for our side screen angles, for me when we measured earlier, it was 76. So we're gonna change that to 76. And looking at the game, everything looks good to me. I don't have to do any more changes on my side. For you, you might have to move your seats up or, you know, forward or back, change the angle. But for me, this actually looks really good. I don't have to do any other changes to where my position is in the car. So we're gonna hit save. And now we can go and enjoy ACC. So when I said a Corsa, the process is very simple. So first of all, we got to go into our options. We go to video and we make sure that full screen is disabled. And we got to make sure here we select triple screens. Once we do that, we can exit out of the game. Now, once we've exited the game, we're going to go into my folders, Assetto Corsa, CFG, and we're going to look for the video.ini file. Once we're in it, we're going to go in and we're going to change our width to 7680 if we're using our, you know, 1440p. And we're going to save that. Exit out. Now we're going to go back into ACC. Now that we're back in ACC, we're going to go back to our options. We're going to go back to our video and we're going to see now our resolution has changed to what our desired resolution is. So now we can go back and go in and actually select what we want to drive. And you can notice we're still here on single monitor because with a set of cores, it doesn't actually go into triples until you actually go into your race. We're going to hit start. It's going to load up. Now we can see that our monitors have switched over to triple screens. All right, we're going to go in. We're going to go and drive. Now we're in the car. So the one thing we got to do now is to set up our FOV correctly. To scroll our mouse all the way to the right, we're going to see this bars pop up. So we're going to go through, we're going to find our triple monitor setup right here. You can see with the triple screens. We're going to click on it. Once we click on the triple screen icon, we're going to get this new screen right here. This is going to help us set up our triple screen monitors. So the rotation spinner right here, this is the angle between our displays, which I measured earlier was going to be 76 for me. So we're going to move it to 76. Here, this is the distance between your eyes and the screen, your distance spinner. So here we're going to adjust it to how we measured. So for me, it was 560. So we're going to move it to 560. All right. The bottom right here, the spinner screen width, that's the width of our screens. So for me, when we measured everything, it was 660 millimeters. So we're going to do that. We've got it lined up pretty good. And now we're going to adjust, you know, our bezels. How much bezels do we have? Even though like I'm using the ASUS bezel free kit, like I still see just a little bit of things going on. So I'm going to go ahead and mess with that real quick to get it lined up. So for me, negative seven for me works perfect where everything looks lined up. And then here we can just close it out. Now we can just go racing. The last title we're going to get everything fixed up for is AMS2. For AMS2, it's a very simple process. We go into options. We go into triple screen. So right now you can see, even though triple screen spanning has been selected, we're still not seeing the side monitor. So what we're going to do is we're going to take it off, take it back on again, and bam, it pops right up. Then we're going to go back. Yes, we got to restart. All right, and then we go into performance. So in performance, we're going to go to borderless. And then what we're going to do, so instead of going up, you're going to go all the way back down as far as you can for your resolution, because that's when it's going to pop up for the resolution of your monitors. So we see it right here. For me, I'm a 1440p. we're going to see 7680 by 1440. So we're down here, we've selected our resolution right here. Now we can go back. It's going to ask us, yes, we need to restart. So we hit OK. Now we're going to exit out of the game and restart it all over again. Before we get back into the game, one thing I forgot to mention to you guys is we need to go into our Automobilista folder. So in our Automobilista folder that's in my documents, we're going to open up our graphicsconfig.dx11. Here we need to make sure we set our refresh rate to what our actual monitors can do, because you couldn't really do it in game. So here for me it's 120, so we're going to set it to 120. And we see that our width and everything is good to go, so we'll save that. Exit out, and now we can go into the game. Now that we got AMS2 set up and ready to go for triple screens, we're going to go in there and adjust things just a little bit. So we're going to go into our triple screen and we're going to adjust our distance to our screen, meaning how far it is from our eyes to the screen. So I have it set at 56. Then we're going to go into our left screen and we're going to set up our angle how it is. So I have it at 76. And then we're going to do the same thing for the right screen. And this is all going to depend on the measurements that you guys came up with when you measured your guys' stuff. Now for me, the bezel part was a little tricky. So what I found that worked for me was I kept the bezel width left and right, kept it at 0. And then on the left screen, I had the right bezel width set to negative 50. And the right screen was negative 0.50. Now we can go in there and we can start a session. Just to make sure everything works correctly. Here we are, so everything looks pretty good. I might have to do some minor tweaks, but if you're gonna do some minor tweaks, here's what you need to do. So you go into options, all right, controls. So you gotta make sure you have some things set up in your controls. So go into edit assignments and we go into camera. So here, make sure you have your seat forward, seat backward, seat up and down, and the seat angle up and down adjusted. So the seat forward is gonna move your seat forward, of course. Backwards, backwards. Seat up and seat down is gonna be your height. And then the seat angle up and down is gonna be the angle of how you're looking towards your car. And I'll show you guys here a little bit how that works. So now we're gonna adjust our FOV. So right now I have my FOV set at 56, which felt a little weird to me. So I'm gonna go ahead and change it to make the car, to make the distance a little bit further. So I'm gonna set it to 64. All right, now this looks a lot better to me. I can see my sides perfectly. And now we can sit here now and adjust our seating position. So that way we moved it a little bit forward. That's a little too high. We're gonna move it down just a smidge. And then we have our angles. So this is where we can adjust our angles to look a little further up, a little further down. But I think this is about good for me right here. And that's it, guys. This is how we set up triple screen surround without surround or iFinity and getting working in AMS2.
Well, guys, I hope this video helped you out. If you enjoyed it, please like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when we have more videos coming out. If you know of better ways of how to do triple screen setups without NVIDIA Surround or iFinity, let me know in the comments below, or if you know how to get it working on rFactor 2. Again, let me know and I can do an updated video on how to get it set up that way too. But anyways, guys, this is it for me. Have fun racing. Later.